Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. So in today's video we will look about for the rotating magnetic field in the induction motor, or rotating magnetic field, how it is produced. That would be the basics of AC machines fundamentals. And you know that generators are the devices that can convert mechanical energy or mechanical power into electrical power, while the motors have the machines which convert the electrical power to the mechanical power. So AC machines actually can be classified as either synchronous or induction machines. So in synchronous motor, magnetic field current is supplied by a separate DC power source, while in the AC machines of the induction motor types, field current is supplied by magnetic induction, which is known as the transformer action, into their field windings. The field circuits are located on their rotors in both of the motors. So the first of all, we have to look for the how these the three phase, either it is an induction motor or it is a synchronous motor, how they have the tendency to rotate by itself. So because the three phase motors are the basic machines in the induction motors or in the synchronous motors, so they inherently have the property that they produce a rotating magnetic field. In the rotating magnetic field, if we just apply a simply three phase supply to the stator. So if we assume that we have these three phases are located as here A prime, B, B prime, C and C prime, and they are especially 120 degree apart from each other. And if you apply a three phase set of voltages, that will produce the three phase set of currents in these windings, which is IA prime, IBB prime, ICC prime. So IM sine omega t and IM sine omega t minus 120 degree, IM sine omega t minus 240 degree. So all of these currents will produce the magnetic field intensity. And as we know that H is equal to Ni by LC. So it means that H is proportional to the current that is in the winding. So based on that, we will have these three magnetic field intensities. So this sine omega t is minus 120 degrees because of this current, and this 120 degree will be the phase shift of this HAA. So this is HAA, and similarly this is a zero phase shift, and this is a 240 degree phase shift. So this is HBB prime and HCC prime. So where HM will include all these parameters which are known as the HM. So because we know that B and H has the direct proportion, and with the only constant of proportionality is the permeability, so the magnetic field flux density will be then BA prime T is equal to BN sine omega T, and similarly all these will be in phase with the magnetic field intensity. So we can see here that HAA prime and BAA prime, they are in phase, and while HBB prime and BBB prime, similarly BCC prime and HCC prime, they are in phase with each other. So only difference is between the magnitudes of them. So this is how that will be produced three magnetic flux densities. Now how this rotating magnetic field can be produced? So the currents and their corresponding flux densities can be examined at specific times to determine the resulting net magnetic field in the stator. So at omega t equals to 0, because this is a rotating rotating field, so we can have the omega t ranging from 0 to 360 degrees. So we can have any value of the omega t at any instant of time t, so that we can we will have some values. So that can be resolved easily because we have these three phases A, B and C, and if we assume A at any point, so we can use this parallelogram a vector resolution method to find out this net magnetic field. So net magnetic field at omega t equals to 0, and if you put this omega t equals to 0 in these equations here, so sine omega t is 0, so this will be sine, this is omega t 0 minus 120 degree, 0 minus 240 degree, and then we just add them together simply, so we will get 1.5 bm angle of minus 90 degree. So minus 90 degree, that it means that it is on this side 90 degree. So if we take omega t equals to 90 degree, so again it will be at plus 90 degree, and it will be by 1.5 bm. And if we look at the very important factor is that this magnitude is constant for all the times. So although this vector is rotating, this net magnetic field density is rotating, but its magnitude is a constant throughout their rotation. So here in this picture animation, we can see that A phase A red, A phase B green, phase C is blue, and the resultant is black R, and it has the 1.5 of the BM, whatever it is BM is. So that is 1.5 times of that magnitude. So it is constant and it's rotating, and it is rotating. So this is called the rotating magnetic field, which is produced in the three phase electric machines. This is how it is being shown again once with some motor. Now there is some important parameters that we must remember before going to the this induction motor that we will see in our next videos. So the rotating magnetic flux in stator B net or BS can be represented by one north pole and one south pole, just like here we have shown here. These magnetic poles complete one mechanical rotation around the stator for each electrical rotation. So it means that if we have just two poles, so that electrical frequency will be equal to mechanical frequency, or in radians per second it will be the same for the two pole. But in general, if we have more than two poles, P by 2, 4 poles P by 2, so we just it will be theta E is equal to P by 2 theta, and F is equal to P by 2 Fm, omega is equal to P by 2 Fm. Means if P is equal to 4, then electrical frequency is 4 times of mechanical frequency. Okay, so it means that because if you know that F is equal to Np by 120, or Nm is equal to 120 F by P. So for 4 pole machine, the mechanical pole move halfway around the stator in one electrical cycle. So it means that theta is equal to 2 times theta m. Sorry, for P is equal to 4, it will be 2. P by 2. So here we have P by 2. 2 Fm. So it will be 2 Fm. Omega is equal to 2 omega m. So it means that one electrical frequency, it will have two mechanical rotations. So so when the three phase set of currents are supplied to this stator, two north poles and two south poles are produced in the stator windings. So theta SE is equal to 2 times theta SM, and FSE is equal to 2 FSM for 4 poles, and omega SE is equal to same for the 4 poles. So here we can see the 4 poles, A1, A1 prime, B1, B1 prime, C1, C1 prime, and then we have the BA2, A2 prime, B2, B2 prime. So we have these four poles. So four pole machines, the mechanical pole move halfway around the stator in one electrical cycle. So that's enough for the this video. If you have any questions, feel free to ask. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.